Guys, so let's do a little recap here on what got accomplished so far in the last day or two. Got all the floors ground down, all the spot welds done up. The doors are finished being welded up where the seams are on the drops coming down to the rockers. About 80% complete on all my floor grinding. Getting closer here. Came to the back over here, trimmed off all the rusty junk on the top, and got my pieces all shrank and stretched up for my lips here. This one here on the back would be kind of for where your weather stripping would go. I did do one before this one on that's underneath the rust here, the rusty part of the body, plug welded down here and here all the way across, and that one's holding the shape back on the tail pan here to match up with my trunk lid that also got installed. And then right now I'm currently working on putting this one in here, which is going to be where the floor pan is going to get spot welded down after it comes off to the back here, and that'll pretty much complete our floors in here. One thing I want to point out is these factory gussets here coming down for support on the rear quarter panel, those are going to have to come out just to finish off the floor pan. I got to get the floor pan under these things, and if you actually look, they're pretty rotten anyway, so we're probably just going to ditch those all together, and I'll probably just cut some new gussets and weld them back into the car once this floor pan piece is in here. So for right now, order of business is first finish tacking this piece into place, and then we'll get those butchered out of here, make the floor pan template, get it in, wrap all that up, and once the floor is pretty much done, I'm going to come back here and add a new piece across the bottom of the tail pan. Not the whole tail pan, because we want to, you know, kind of maintain this patina on this car, which actually it is really cool looking. So we're just going to do like the bottom inch and a half here, just to the top of the rust, get a new piece welded in there, maybe put a little red oxide primer on it and kind of try to match it to the body. And once that's done, we can finish up the work on the corners and get the bumper on the back of this. And that pretty much wraps up all the floor pans and the body work on the back of the car. After that, we can move on to the front and get the grill on and wrap this thing up and get it ready to paint the chassis. So I'm gonna get these two brackets cut out, and we'll make that last piece of floor pan and wrap up the back of this car today, hopefully. Okay. All right, guys, well, I got all my trunk latch hardware re-welded up and put back together, reshaped out this piece here. This goes in front just to kind of keep the latch centered out. This here is for the adjuster for the actual latch part of the floor part, so we're pretty much ready on that. Probably going to have to lift the floor up a little bit for that, because originally the floor came up above this lip about, I don't know, like 3/4 of an inch. But floors are all done, welded up, ready to go. Let the paint dry on that stuff a little bit more. I'm probably going to have Mike climb in the trunk, not me, climb in the trunk to get that latch kind of figured out. But in the meanwhile, I got these two plates cut here. I'm going to put these back down on these rear body mounting bolts, plug weld them in these four holes on the outside, and then get a gusset back in off of that up to here where those factory style ones were in there earlier. And then we'll move on and get down here and replace this. And the floors are pretty much all done except for that one spot over the tunnel up there, which isn't going to get done till the engine comes out and the body's off, because it's just easier to do it that way. So let's get this stuff welded in, and then we'll move on to this piece down here. Guys, well, that's pretty much gonna be it for this go around. Got my tail pan all on. I did not finish my edges out here because I'm gonna wait to do that for when I get the thing jacked back up and the tires off. I need to get the tires off one more time to finish off the filler neck, get that to the tank, and end up patching the bottom of these fenders. And we'll probably kind of do that at the same time, make sure this lines up with the new shape of the fender here, because this stuff is just kind of hanging off in the breeze right now. So we'll have to make another day out of that whole deal. One thing I did do off camera here is got my trunk latch in, which it turned out pretty good. I guess one of the things, like to be expected, the bolts came out right on the edge of that bead roll, so kind of had to add that little plate there, but that turned out pretty good. It latches down really nice. I used the original factory stuff for mounting it and for the adjustment down here on the bottom. Also had to add a little plate on this, as you can see there, to kind of match it up with that bead roll. But it all turned out pretty good. I also did a little jacking and hammering on this back here too. This gap was kind of wide in the middle, and I pretty much assumed it was going to be. It was hit pretty hard here, and the bottom edge of the decklet is almost kind of curled up, but had a 2x4 in there a little bit, pushing the decklet a little bit, and it came out pretty good. So that's pretty much where I'm going to leave you guys off now. Next time, I think we're going to end up putting the divider wall inside of it between the front area and the trunk, and then we'll move on and get the grill shell and everything done. So, thanks for watching, guys. Appreciate it. Till next time.